Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. And today in this video I'm going to show you the full process of regraining using DasGrain. So here I have a few examples where I'm going to show you the different methods of regraining process, because in DasGrain we have multiple ways to regrain the comb. In this example you can see I have a four setup here, and we will going to see all of them one by one. So the first one, you can see we have this basic regrain setup, and the second one is the scatter grain, and the third one is scatter plus plate grain. The last one is the external grain. We will see how to use the external grain input, and then we will see how to apply on the actual comb. So these are just checkerboard with some element just to simulating a plate. We have a regrain plate also here, so we will see all the methods of regraining, then we will apply those on the actual plate. So let's see the one by one. So the first one is very basic. We have a basic regrain setup. So in this one we have the comb. So this is the actual comb and this is the plate one, and you can, if I compare, these are the changes we did. So this is the plate and we remove some stuff here and we added this rays or whatever. So this is like a simulating a comb. We have a denoise plate here. So let's add a DasGrain first. So let's take a new DasGrain, and as the input says, let's connect. This is the comb input, this is the plate, and this is the denoise plate, right? We connected successfully. Now let's open this one, and first thing you have to do, just analyze this one. So it will basically compare the plate and denoise, the plate grain and the denoise plate, and based on that it will add a grain on your comb. So now if I zoom in, you can see the grain is exactly matching with the comb. If I compare, it's matching in the comb. This is you will get if you just, you know, doing a grain, just comparing these two, plate and denoise, and adding a grain on top. But you can see while we have the darker area, if I compare with the denoise, you can see there are, you may think there are no change, it's just removing the noise, but if I see the actual comb with the regrain, you can see there are some issues coming up. You can see here these issues are here also, and in this area also, if I zoom in a bit, you can see some dark area coming up. So this is because of the denoise is not properly done, and because the plate is not simple, it have very dark areas like this one and very bright areas like here. So that's why when you apply directly comparing these two together, you also get some texture information from the plate. You can see here I'm getting this one, and you can see here this purple thing here, it's coming because of the this comparison. But if you comb something here, and if you have some prep, like in here I basically simulating a prep task, so I remove these things and adding this guardrail here, all those things, so that time this not gonna help. You will get some issues like this here. We can see this part here also, this big one, this one, and here we also have that. So let me just open this one, and if I, so this is a setup I did, and not here, this denoise one. So if you have a fully match it, then you are not gonna see this issue. See, if I off this one, you can see we get some line here, some darkness. If I press one, now it's matching with blade 1:1. Now we're not gonna see this issue, otherwise you will see this darkness. So let's see if I make it 0.5, and if I go back to my comp and if I compare with plate, you may think, oh, this is properly regrained, but in here you will see these patches, these lines and everything. So that's why if you're doing some prep tasks like this one, then you don't need to use this basic setup, you need to move to the scatter one. So let's see the scatter one. Add a DasGrain here again, and let's see how scatter will help us to, you know, fix those issues what we see in the first example. Just press analyze, and we get the same issue like here, you get issues. But in the DasGrain, if you go here into replace tab, and if we enable this scatter activation, and then we get this selection box. So this will calculate the grain from the plate. So if I view my plate, so I can sample from anywhere in the plate. So it's better to, you know, sample from dark areas, but not like this one. So I'm sampling from here because this is just a constant, this is just a checkerboard, the grain is unified in everywhere. So I'm sampling here, and now if I view here, now if I compare with this to this basic setup one, you can see we don't see that issue. And by the way, in this comb this is very basic, so there is no transformation here. But in the second example, if I compare, you can see we have a lot of changes here. If I compare with the plate, so this is the plate and this is the actual comb. So in the comb we add the guard rays, we have a transformation okay, and we also remove some stuff here, and we also have a saturation reduction in the comp. Now if I use this one scatter, you're not gonna see any change here. I mean, the grain is consistent across all the area and is matching with the plate, but because we have a repo, so that's why. But the grain size, you can see the grain size is same, it's not scaling or down the grain is the same amount, and the size also is the same. This is very useful when you doing a scatter. And if you enable this one in the scatter tab, you can see we have this overlay. You will see we have this pattern here. So this pattern is basically we are sampling from this box, and we are scattering that's grain in everywhere with this Voronoi pattern Y. And you can increase the size. You can see the grain is same, only the grain sample is scattering everywhere with larger area. And we have this more control here, edge correction, so you can see it's distorting the edge to make it more random. Then we can't see this line here, otherwise if you view this one, we will see this straight line cut. So it's very hard to see, but you can see this is the line here, and if you do this now, it's break, so we can't see that straight line. So that is the idea here. This is how scattering is working. So it scatter this sample grain to entire frame, so you can view and you can change some setting here. So this is mostly we are using this scattering method. If you have your plate like this one, transformation and retime or whatever, we are using this method. And now we have this scatter plus plate grain. So this is very unique one. We're not using this mostly, but sometimes you have to use, because sometimes scatter is not working well. What I mean by that, when you scatter something, so in the darker area you see more grain compared to the plate like this one. So that time we are using the scatter and plate grain together. So I will show you how. Let's connect this one and let's analyze. So now we get this one, and we go here and let's enable the scatter first, and let's sample the area maybe like here. So we get this. So now the thing is, we have this plate and we have this thing here, right? We only want to add a grain where we did some changes. So for example, if we check the alpha, so these are the changes I did. I actually forgot to add this circle here. Let's leave it right now, but you get the point. Okay, so these are the changes we have, and we have this alpha. So we have this guardrail here, and we remove this area, so that's why we have this alpha. So in here we have this mass input here. So this mass input is very useful. Let's connect this to this. So we are using this alpha in the DasGrain. If you go to the replace tab, we have this button called replace grain. So let's enable this one. So let's enable, and now let's view the overlay cell pattern. So now you can see whatever the scatter grain, this first the scatter grain, we are only adding where we have this alpha, right? And everywhere else we are using a plate grain. So it's like doing a two things together. First we are comparing grain with the denoise plate, and we are adding that grain here in those areas. And then we are comparing grain, and we are sampling that scatter grain from this area, and we are scattering only where the alpha is. So now view this one, and let's disable this overlay. So now here we have a scatter grain. So let me just quickly show. If I move this box, you can see only this grain change. Here is not changing at all, because here is matching plate grain 1:1. You can see that grain is staying same, only the reposition is changing. But here the grain is changing, because here in those area we are adding a scatter grain. See, that's how this thing is work, and this is very useful, because we are using a two methods to adding a regrain. First we are comparing with plate, and then we are adding grain here in these areas, and second we are sampling a grain from certain areas from the plate, and then we are scattering on the specific alpha. So in this case we have this alpha, and we are scattering here, and then we have a more control over on the scatter grain. You can go here and you can, you know, tweak some setting here, and you can frequency, and you can blend this thing more from this side. And if you do like, you can, you know, go here, add a filter erode in your alpha itself, and you can blend more like this with the original plate. So now it's blending, now the grain is blending with the original grain here like this. So you have more control over here. So that's how you can use this one. If I facing some issues in the scatter, I will use this scatter plus plate grain together like this one. So this is the another method of using DasGrain. And now the last one is external grain. So let's use a DasGrain here. First of all, I will show you the external grain. So let's connect these together. Let's analyze again. So in this one you can see a lot of things are changed. First of all, this thing, we have this warping, we are adding this thing, we are removing some stuff like this, and we have this repositioning and scaling, all those things are happening, right? Sometimes it's very hard to regrain some plate, even if you have a denoise plate. That time, as I said, we have some changes here also, you can see the brightness change. So sometimes you get a plate, the actual grain plate. In this case, we have this grain plate. If I expose this, you can see it's only contain the grain. So we need to add this grain in this comb using DasGrain. So if you zoom in the DasGrain and if you make it little down, you can see there is one input, and if you hover over and if you view, it's saying external grain. So if I connect this to this external grain plate, nothing going to happen because we need to go inside the DasGrain, go to the replace tab, and we need to use this checkbox, use external grain. So now I'm not using scatter, I'm not using a plate grain, but I'm using external grain. But it's comparing this thing and this, we need to add this grain. If you zoom in and let's off this one, you can see the off this one is using a plate grain directly, and you get some issues here. And if I use this one, now I'm not using a plate grain, I'm using a external grain plate. So if I add a grade and if I do some changes, we can see the grain is changing. So see that grain amount reducing and increasing because I'm doing changes here and it's affecting here. So that's confirmed that I'm using this external grain here, and this grain is applying to my comb. Sometimes in production we also get the external plate grain like this. We have this random grain in a separate EXR file, and then we using this external grain to doing a regraining process. When you have a heavy retime, and when you have a heavy comb like this, repo and warping, cleanup, many things are there, and so that time this plate and denoise is not working. So that time we are using an external grain to add a separate grain, and that external grain is coming from exactly the same camera as the main plate is shoot with. So then it will match 1-to-1. That is the method of using DasGrain. I mostly used these two methods, and this one is very rarely we use because it need an external plate. Most of the time it's not required to use external plane. Most of the job done with the plate and denoise plate. So these two is my go-to regraining with DasGrain. This one it's not, as I said, it's need to match with the plate 1-to-1, and if you have some heavy cleanup, then you will get some issue like this. It's basically showing you the textures. All right, it's comparing with the denoise, and when you do denoise, you lost some textures like this one you can see here, and that time when you regrain, you will see the texture inside your comb also. So that's why scatter plus plate grain is very helpful here. So now let's apply this in this actual comb. So I already did this in my live stream, so if you have not checked, make sure to go and check the live stream. And let's shuffle out those passes. So we have this degrain plate, so we have this plate and you have the denoise. You can see the denoise and the plate, we have this grain, so we need to add that grain into our comb. So let's use a DasGrain here again. Let's connect the comb to comb, plate to plate, and denoise to denoise. All right, now let's press analyze first and let's wait. Okay, now the grain is added back, but as I said, we don't need to directly add grain as it is because sometimes we get some textures from the background. If I zoom in, if I do some gamma correction, you will see we have these patterns of some random patterns here, so that will appear in the grain itself. We don't want that. Let's use a scatter, enable scatter, and from here I will place somewhere here, so it will only use that grain. If I zoom in and let's expose this one, you can see we added a grain from the plate like this. See, now this is the grain we added. Now let's simulate that issue. So let's add a transform. Let's assume our comb have some reposition, some rotation like this, and some heavy CC like this. We have very dark areas here and very bright areas there. So this is our comb and this is the plate. Let's regrain this one. So in this one we can use scatter one pretty easily because we are adding a grain overall. But as I said, if I want, we can only in this one we don't have that alpha, so we are replacing only this area. So what I'm going to do, I'm just roughly show you the process what we just saw in the beginning. So as you can see, so this is what I'm simulating here. So we have this roto which is matching with the with this thing. So in this one we are using scatter plus plate grain. So I connected the mask input here, so scatter is connected. Let's view this one and let's use this one, and now you can see I'm only replacing the grain where that input is, and let's me just align this roto. So this is just to show you the point. If you have that alpha from this comp, so you can easily replace grain with this one like this. So now let's disable this one first of all. Cell overlay. So we are adding grain only this area. You can see, I hope you can see in the compression. So this is the grain we are adding here, but here we are adding the plate grain directly. So here the grain is same. I am not sure you can see that grain is same, only the image is shifting. So this is very good way to, you know, maintaining the original grain from the actual plate and only adding a grain where we are replacing the background or some stuff here. As I said, I mostly use these two, the scatter one and the scatter plus plate grain. It's totally depend on the shot by shot, but you have to know the different types of regraining method you can do with the DasGrain. So this is just a very basic, this is not very deeply, I'm just scratching the surface of DasGrain. If you go inside, there are many stuff you can, you know, change inside DasGrain based on your shot by shot. And we haven't talked about this, you know, this luminance thing also. So this is also very important. So one thing you can do, make sure you, where luminance thing is going always on positive direction. So like this one, so you can right click here and just go to interpolation after and linear. So it will go straight up on the positive side. I will put the link of this actual DasGrain tutorial where you can see why it's important, and you need to watch that so you can understand the DasGrain process, how it's working and how you can use DasGrain in your shot, because every shot is not the same. Based on the shot by shot, you have to check which regraining method is going to work. So that is from my side. So I hope you learned something about DasGrain, the regraining process and all those things. Please let me know in the comment what do you think about this, and if you have any questions, please also write down below. And make sure to join my server where we have 500 plus members. Make sure to subscribe, like and share. Thank you for watching. We will see you in a very next one. Have a great day.